Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to American Tune. We are going to react to this song for the first time. It's a song by Paul Simon, never heard this song before. Have heard a couple of songs of Simon and Garfunkel, but this song American Tune is the first time that we
have. I've never heard this either. Never
came across the title as well.
Never, yeah.
So it should be exciting. What is it about? American Tune, so it may be talking about America as a country or the fond, the connection of Paul Simon with his country, something like that.
And when it comes to songs like these, it's very important that we both mention that we are not from America.
We are not Americans, we are two Indians.
Yeah, we are two Indians, we are humble Indians from Mumbai.
Yeah.
We are very proud though, even though we are humble. Very, very proud of our roots, our culture, our land.
Everyone should
and
be.
Everything almost to do with India.
Yeah.
So, when we give our perspective as open, honest reviewers, definitely we may not understand certain things in the song. And I'm saying this with experience with similar songs in the past 2 years that we have reacted to and listened to. There are two things that we do on Enoma. One is we listen to songs and second we react to them.
Yeah.
Not many people understand what that means. They think both are the same thing. Because in our title tag, we just can put reaction. We really can't fill it up with too many keywords, which we would like to mention. We'd like to mention a few things about us.
Yeah.
But there's no opportunity because it's just 64 characters or less. So the fact is, we give an open, honest review. And it's from our country. It's based on our upbringing, our culture, our values, our knowledge as counselors, teachers and life coaches. We have interacted with lots of people. Both of us in the last 10 years for Kirti and more than 25 years now for me, we have reacted with people from across the world, 50 plus countries as clients, students who have been our clients and students. And my experience has taught me a lot about different lands. So when it comes to America, I may not have lived there for a long time, but I do know a lot about America. At times I believe I'm more American than an actual American is. But that's not good. That's not good really. I would rather be who I am, which is Indian.
Sailing in two ships isn't good.
Yeah. So when we react to this, please keep in mind that we are just somebody.
We reacted to American Pie. We reacted to three songs by Elvis Presley. And one was Dixieland, one was Trilogy and something.
And I find it really cheap and disrespectful when people come and say, oh, you don't get it, you're Indian. And things like that, comments on those lines. My only request to you is don't watch this reaction video. We've not yet started.
No.
Stop.
One thing.
If you are in that category of people, we don't really want to associate with you.
We can't.
Kirti would say the same thing, but she's a bit more nicer and diplomatic. I'm not. Please leave right now. We don't have any place in our lives or channel or reactions for people like you who have no respect for people from around the world. Other skin colors, other occupations, other age groups, other genders, other lifestyles, other cultures.
An American woman may never ever have had worn a sari with a veil in front of her face. That happens in India. It happens in India. And you won't understand. You will say, what? How do you live your life? It happens. That's how different cultures can be. Can we really take offense of those things? I don't think so.
I guess with a land which has so many incidences of rapes, molestation and incest, and I'm not talking about India, I guess they need to start wearing those kind of clothes, right? Let's get started to protect themselves from those creeps and psychos. American Tune by Paul Simon. Let's get started.
Many is the time I've been mistaken, and many times confused. Yes, and I've often felt forsaken, and certainly misused. Oh, but I'm all right, I'm all right. I'm just weary to bones.
Beautiful singing.
Still, you don't expect to be bright and bon vivant so far away from home. so far away from home. And I don't know a soul who's not been battered. I don't have a friend who feels at ease. I don't know a dream that's not been shattered or driven to its knees. Ah, but it's alright, it's alright, for we've lived so well so long. Still, when I think of the road we're traveling on, I wonder what's gone wrong. Can't help but wonder what's gone wrong. And I dreamed I was dying. I dreamed that my soul rose unexpectedly, and looking back down at me, smiled reassuringly. And I dreamed I was flying high up above. My eyes could clearly see the Statue of Liberty sailing away to sea. And I dreamed I was flying. Oh, we come on the ship they call the Mayflower. We come on the ship that sailed the moon. In the ages most uncertain hours, and sing an American tune. Oh, and it's alright, it's alright, it's alright. You can't be forever blessed. Still, tomorrow's gonna be another working day, and I'm trying to get some rest. That's all I'm trying, to get some rest.
Wow, that was a loud applause for this song. Wow. What are your thoughts and feelings? I enjoyed the way he was singing. I enjoyed most aspects of the song. Even the lyrics, certain lines were very profound. What are your thoughts and feelings?
I like the guitar. I like his voice. What I like the most is a common man's life in his country. And sometimes he can be feeling low. Sometimes he can be feeling very, very tired, weary. But one, you know, there are certain things that cheer them up or give them a reason why they are living or why they are doing things. And that could be something in their country, something to be proud of, something to belong to. And that's what he's talking about. A very basic person. Probably he works somewhere on a daily wage or something. But and certain days he's very tired. Certain days he's really, you know, hopeless. But when he sees the Statue of Liberty, his entire mood changes. Or at least he gets some hope and inspiration.
He sees it in his dreams, though.
Yeah.
What I got from the beginning is that he's perhaps in a serving abroad.
Okay.
I got from the beginning itself that I think he's not in America.
Yeah, that's what I thought. So but later on, away, I thought he's
away from home and he's working, maybe serving this country, working somewhere on some assignment. And this is what he feels. He's missing home.
Missing home.
And I connect with that as an Indian too. You know, they are obviously many family members and friends are all over the world. India is one of the countries after China which has the maximum immigrants, you know, migrants. People from here go all over the world. I don't think there's a single country in the world
that won't have
an Indian community there.
Yeah.
So, and same goes with China and a couple of other countries, but just a couple.
Yeah.
So the fact is that you know, I get this, knowing people in my family who, and friend circle, close friends who live abroad, they connect more with India when they are serving abroad or when they're working abroad.
Yeah.
So same goes with Paul Simon. As an American citizen, I'm assuming he's an American citizen.
Yeah.
So he serves, he's probably on tour because of his music duties or what he's doing as a musician.
Yeah.
He's probably on tour, he's probably a writer, he's probably someone. He's talking about anyone who's serving abroad,
yeah,
outside of America.
Yeah.
And, you know, he does think about home. So that's what I got. Mm-hmm. That's what I got. But mm-hmm, possibly I missed the next part, so I don't know if I'm right.
Okay.
Beautiful song though. I absolutely love the emotion in his voice. I love the way he sang it. He owned it. And that's when, you know, when songwriters, I'm assuming he's written it, and songwriters write their own songs, or musicians rather write their own songs,
mm-hmm,
most times they own it. And it's a more fulfilling experience. Even though I don't completely connect with some of the lines, as an Indian, I still can relate to it.
Yeah.
I don't completely connect, but I can relate to it. And that's the beauty of it. That's the beauty of the way he owned the lines,
yeah,
and the way he sung it. Good song. Really good song.
It must be a great song for an American actually being abroad and, you know, thinking, missing home.
I'm not sure if I'm right about that, Kirti. Mm-hmm. I'm just assuming because it started off that way.
Mm-hmm.
So it may not be only for Americans abroad. It may be for...
It's the best song, I think, when you're abroad or when you're out is Country Roads.
Yeah. Well, especially on your way back home.
I know.
Country
that
roads.
Just fits the mood, that just fits the excitement, enthusiasm and everything.
Yeah. I wonder which is, you know, songs which are truly American classics or anthems which every American loves to hear.
I would say Country Roads would be one of them, and apart from that, I don't know.
I don't think Country Roads, because Country Roads is more for West Virginia and people from that part of the country.
Okay.
I'm talking about, you know, this is one song.
A neutral song that you're...
For every American. Every American, yeah, every skin color, every community,
anyone.
Not discriminating against anyone.
Yeah.
You know, there are 4 million Indians in America.
Yeah.
From our country.
Yeah.
So that's a lot. So including all these kind of communities.
Yeah. What is that one song?
Yeah.
Which apart is from national anthem,
I don't think there is. I don't think there is a single song in America.
Okay.
I can think of 50 in India. That's how amazing it is to belong to such a country.
Yeah, actually.
But I don't think there's a single one in America. So I would like to
one song for the entire nation.
I would like to know these
apart
songs.
Apart from national anthem.
We come across so many Americans, but they don't have a song of their own. Oh, I mean, apart from the anthem.
All in one.
That would be nice. Hopefully this is one of them. But I still feel it's about outsiders.
Uh-huh.
People who are working abroad, Americans.
Okay.
That's it for this one. Goodbye.